If you have a 40-inch by 20-inch flat piece of cardboard, what dimensions of an open-top box will produce the most volume? Looking at our diagram here, let's go ahead and call the length of this side here 40 inches. The length of this side here 20 inches. The idea here is you want to cut out squares from the corner and then fold the sides up to form a box that looks something like this. The issue here is we don't know what size squares to cut out of the corners to maximize the volume, but we do know they're squares, so let's let the length of each side of the square equal x. And all the squares are congruent. So the length of this side from here to here would represent this edge on our box, and the length of this side here would represent the length of this edge here on the box. And because we're cutting out squares that are x by x, the length of this x here would be the height of the box. So let's go ahead and call this x. Now the entire length from here to here is 40 inches, and we take away this length, which is x, and take away this length, which is x. 40 minus 2x would be the length of this green side here. And the same thing happens on this side. If the length from here to here is 20, and we need the length of this blue segment here, it'd be 20 minus x, or 20 minus 2x. So this edge here would have a length of 40 minus 2x, and this edge here would have a length of 20 minus 2x. So this is all the information we need in order to write our volume function. The volume of this box going to be equal to the length times the width times the height, or the product of these three dimensions. So we'll have x times 20 minus 2x times the quantity 40 minus 2x. So now we'll determine this product and then maximize our function by determining where the first derivative is equal to 0. Let's first multiply these two binomials. We'll have 800 minus 40x minus 80x, that's minus 120x, and then plus 4x squared. Now we'll distribute the x, and I'm going to go ahead and put these terms in descending order. So I'll have 4x cubed minus 120x squared plus 800x. So now to determine the maximum volume, we'll find the derivative and determine whether the derivative is equal to 0 or does not exist. So we'll have 12x squared minus 240x plus 800. Now the derivative is a polynomial function, so it will exist for all values of x. So let's go ahead and set this equal to 0 and solve. We can factor out a 4 from these three terms, so we'll have 4 times the quantity 3x squared minus 60x plus 200 equals 0. Now, unfortunately, this does not factor. So that means we have to determine the critical numbers by using the quadratic formula. So we'd have a equal to 3, b equal to negative 60, and c equal to 200. And the quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And to save some time, I've already done this. The solutions would be x is approximately 15.8 and x is approximately 4.2. But notice how we still don't know if these x values produce maximums or minimums for the volume. But there is one thing that we can do. Notice how the length of this side here is 20 minus 2x. So if x was equal to 15.8, the length of this side here would be negative, which obviously is not possible. So we can exclude this as a possible value of x. But we do want to verify that this x value does produce a maximum. And we can do that by determining if the function is concave up or concave down at this value of x. So we'll determine the second derivative of the volume function and then evaluate it at x equals 4.2. So the second derivative of the volume function would be 24x minus 240. So now let's evaluate this at x equals 4.2. So this is going to be 100.8 minus 240, which is obviously going to be less than 0. So if the second derivative is negative, that means the function will be concave down, which means at 4.2 we would have a relative maximum. So now that we know that x equals 4.2 maximizes the volume, we can determine the dimensions of this box. The dimensions would be x by 20 minus 2x by 40 minus 2x. And all the units are in inches. So the dimensions of our box would be 4.2 inches by 11.6 inches by 31.6 inches, which means the maximum volume would be approximately equal to the product of these three, which is 1,539.6 cubic inches. So these are the solutions that we were looking for this problem. The dimensions that give us the maximum volume and what that volume would be. I hope you found this explanation helpful.